Hello everyone, welcome to this session on patents. Here we are going to discuss about Patents Act 1970 in India. In that topic of discussion here is patent compulsory license. So compulsory license, one case study we are going to discuss here. Earlier in one of the session we have discussed about what is compulsory license and when it is given. So what are the conditions for giving the compulsory license and how to apply for that and what are the different provisions. So that we have already discussed. You can refer that session by the link provided in the description. So this is the very important case of compulsory license, because this was the first compulsory license which was granted under Patent Act in India. So India grants first compulsory license under Patents Act. So we are going to discuss that case, and that case was between Bayer Pharma and Natco. Bayer Pharma and Natco. Natco is generic manufacturer in India, while Bayer is multinational pharmaceutical. So here what happened, let us have some background. So India joined WTO, that is World Trade Organization, and then after that there was a need to change in patent law which are compliant to TRIPS. There was a TRIPS agreement, that is trade related aspects of intellectual property rights. So in 2005 the Patent Act was amended. So there were amendments, and after that amendment what happened is India is allowing the product patents. Before that only process patent was allowed. So after that product patent was allowed in health sector, means in pharmaceuticals. So that was opposed by local industries. Now why local industries were opposing? Because if some pharmaceutical company from the other country is taking patent in India for their pharmaceutical product, then there may be a monopoly in a market. They may sell drug at a higher price, so Indian people may not afford it. So that is the reason, that was the reason, and that local manufacturer, which were the generic manufacturer, so they cannot manufacture that drug without the license. So because of that there was a oppose by the local industries, and after that strong oppose there were the some provisions were added for the compulsory licenses. So there were certain terms and conditions for the compulsory licenses. So here this first application for this was filed by Natco in July 2011. Here in this case the drug Nexavar, which was patented by Bayer in India. So Bayer was the foreign company and it has a patent for the drug Nexavar, and this drug this brand was containing sorafenib, that was the drug which was used in a cancer, in a treatment of cancer. So for applying the compulsory license, what were the claims which were given by the Natco? That this drug is not available at a reasonable price. That was number one. Number two, the invention, means that patent, is not working in India. And number three, that the company, the patent holder, patentee, buyer, imports the drug in spite of they have a manufacturing facility in India. So based on all these three conditions, Natco has applied for the compulsory license. So these claims, after the claims of the Natco Pharma, Bayer has also defended that. So what were the defense done by the buyer? That reasonable price is to be calculated on the basis of public and patentee. That means Bayer was trying to say that their drug is available at reasonable price, and along with the public, the reasonable price to be calculated on the basis of patentee also, that patentee must patentee shall also afford the drug selling at the price. So that was the defense given by the Bayer Pharma. Another thing was given by the Bayer Pharma was class of patients who can afford at present price. So Bayer was trying to say that there is a class of patients or class of the people who can afford this drug at the present price. So that was another defense. And third defense was that relatively small demand, only 2% of the patients of Nexavar are there, so not manufactured in India, and they are importing that drug from the outside. So these three were the defense, and this the third claim, it was going to get against the Bayer Pharma because they themselves said that there is a relatively small demand. So that means patent is not working. Another thing they said that they are importing it from outside of the India. So import is not allowed. So this thing went against of the Bayer Pharma. Another major thing was their price. This price was for the treatment including Nexavar was costing 2.5 lakhs per month for that patient, and patient need to take it for a longer duration of the time. So the cost of the treatment was increasing, and for the average people, average Indian, this price was not affordable. So against that, what Natco was claiming, Natco, that generic manufacturer who has applied for the compulsory license, what they were saying that they will sell the drug at the price for which the treatment cost per month is 8,900 rupees. So there is a huge difference between the cost of the treatment. Again, they said that they will maintain the price, they will not increase the price. Another thing, they said that their drug will be available for Indian people, they will not export it. And another thing, they said that they will give free treatment to 600 deserving patients each year. So this were the offered by Natco Pharma against the Bayer. So this was the difference between what Bayer was offering and what Natco is about to offer. So the main reason was affordable price and working of the patent. So because of that, patent office granted a compulsory license to Natco Pharma for the generic version of Nexavar. If you have any doubts, you can contact me.